It was like the horse and buggy days.
The internet was an experiment.
Basically just for fun.
To make stuff happen.
There was something bigger here.
And that started 44Net.
Billions of people access the internet on a radio. But 44 years ago, radio amateurs were among the first to put the internet on the airwaves. I'm John Burwell, 44Net Program Manager for ARDC. We asked the people who were there to tell us their stories about how hackers and hams laid the foundations of the modern internet as we celebrate 44 years of 44Net.
I got a Z80 board. I got a board with a SDLC chip on it, and I started programming that on December 10th, 1980. From my house, I put up the first packet radio beacon, and every minute it would bleed out, it's, hello, I'm a packet radio repeater. People started hearing it, and they started wondering, what is this thing? What's going on?
I got a board from Vancouver Area Digital Communications Group, the VADCG board, and was trying to use that to get to Hank's computers in Menlo Park. It wasn't a very usable connection, but it was amazing, you know, sort of like the bear that dances. It was amazing that it danced at all.
As hams got all of these packet radio repeaters and digipeaters, we had a backbone up and down the West Coast. You could transfer mail from Washington to California.
And it was happening over ham frequencies, which was really kind of cool.
The university groups started using TCP/IP, and I was of course watching what was going on. And Phil Karn was, I think, very much attuned to that set of communications protocols.
The whole idea of the internet was to be able to take a whole bunch of different physical networks to be able to run the internet protocols above all these different link level protocols and draw them together.
I was thinking to myself, well, if we're going to use that, we need IP addresses. And John Postel was the keeper of ARPANET numbers. So I gave him a phone call one day and said, hey, there's an amateur radio community that's developing digital communications. I'd like to get some IP addresses so that we can be official. And that started 44Net.
Way back in the mid 80s when I started writing this TCP/IP internet package for ham radio, basically just for fun.
Phil had gotten enough code working to demonstrate that it was not just theoretically, but truly possible to implement that networking stack running on a processor that an average ham could hope to own and have at home.
And I remember the first night sitting at a terminal talking to somebody in LA, just keyboard to keyboard chats, and thinking, this is pretty cool.
So that was sort of when the TCP/IP stack became a credible alternative for people to play with at home as hams.
I had driven to Harrisburg, Pennsylvania to attend a get-together.
Something called the Mid-Atlantic Packet Radio Council.
And a couple guys in Pittsburgh showed up.
Mike Chaponis, K3MC, who was a postgraduate researcher at Carnegie Mellon, and Bob Hoffman, N3CVL, who was the lead sysadmin for the computer science department at University of Pittsburgh down the hill.
And this guy named Beadle Garby.
While the meeting was happening, we didn't realize, but it snowed. We came out, there was a lot of snow on the ground.
And there was no way I was going to drive back back to New Jersey.
And Bob was concerned about driving back across the Penn Turnpike in the snow. And so we looked around, and across the parking lot was some motel thing.
We decided to just core our heels there for the night.
We sat up most of the night kibitzing about packet radio and TCP/IP over packet radio.
And had an impromptu discussion of how to start deploying 44Net.
And by the time we gave up for the night, we had committed to make stuff happen. That was the formation of the TCP group, which became the 44Net community later.
It took a few years to realize that there was something bigger here.
And it meant that people who had more niche interests could collaborate more effectively over long distance.
And if you give people a new qualitatively new way to communicate, even if it's hard to use, they will be the path to your door.
Look back at those years and with great satisfaction.
We were in this place that understood radio technology and understood internet technology and saw how they would be better together than apart. And that ended up changing the world.
Thank you.